of modern-day lighthouse keepers is working to keep the history of the profession burning bright in the minds of visitors to one of our state's beloved national parks. These two volunteers are unlike most others. Married for 54 years, they volunteer to spend a month of every summer living on an uninhabited island. A guiding light for generations of ship captains navigating the shallow waters and sandy shoals of the Outer Banks, the Cape Lookout Lighthouse served as a navigational beacon. But today, lighthouses are preserved for history, and leisurely recreation is what guides most people to them.
Of all the other lighthouses, this one is the only one. You have to take effort to get here, come by boat to get here. And then secondly, when you look down from the top of this lighthouse, you won't see cars, houses, McDonald's, streets, etc. All you see is just God's green, this primitive, beautiful place.
Larry and Paula Green spend about a month of every summer living upstairs in the old lighthouse keeper's quarters. They run the first floor museum where visitors can cool off and learn about the grueling work of a lighthouse keeper. Built in 1859, the light burned from sunset to sunrise. The keepers had to carry two 45-pound oil cans up 216 iron spiral stairs to the top of the 163-foot-tall lighthouse every day.
I look up at that lighthouse and I see, you know, those black things way up at the top in the glass, and that's what they would hang on to and step on that second railing, the second circular, to clean the glass. Can you imagine?
I read online that they had to clean every day.
Oh, they worked it. They work hard. They really do work hard.
Today, the keeper's quarters are filled with nothing but enthusiasm for the people who come to enjoy nature's beauty.
No place like it that we see. Went to Hawaii one time and did a tour of Hawaii, and I told the guy after we finished, I said, you know, you got a really pretty place here, but have you ever seen Cape Lookout? That's just how I feel about it, you know.
I love watching the kids. You know, they just go, oh, and when they come back, I climbed all the way to the top. You know, those are, to me, that's what it's, I guess it's the teacher in me, but I like that awe moment from kids. That's my favorite part.
The National Park Service maintains the Cape Lookout National Seashore and Lighthouse, but the U.S. Coast Guard maintains the lamp.
The light itself has changed with modern technology over the last 159 years. The newest one is a solar-powered LED.
The previous light relied on diesel generators and shore power. Now, the visitor center, lighthouse, and keeper's quarters are totally off-grid.
What is it like to wake up out here?
Oh my goodness. You look out your bedroom window and you see the sound. You look out your kitchen window and you see this gorgeous lighthouse. I mean, what is there to, it's just, oh, it's wonderful. It's beautiful.
It's a view they say they'll never take for granted. And while you won't find them carrying oil cans, you could say the greens burn a different kind of light as modern day lighthouse keepers guiding generations to come.
Park rangers are actually getting complaints about the new Cape Lookout light almost daily because the solar-powered LED doesn't make that circular sweeping motion that the last one did. But that old light that did that was only installed about 30 years ago. The light has changed almost generationally over the last 100-plus years, and the Coast Guard says this new one is saving taxpayers millions of dollars. You can read the extended version of this story with much more information on that at WITN.com. Still ahead.